You started your fat loss phase and are noticing good progress, but after a while, progress slows down and may even come to a halt. What gives, and how can we break through such a fat loss plateau? Some people might think that it's time to start lowering your calories and start doing more cardio immediately, but there are a few other solutions we can look into first. In today's video, I will give you 3 science-based solutions to a fat loss plateau so that you can continue making good fat loss progress and eventually achieve your fat loss goals. But first, it's important that we have a clear definition of a fat loss plateau. I sometimes get messages from individuals saying that they are in a fat loss plateau because they only lost 1 pound this week, and obviously that's not the true fat loss plateau. Your fat loss progress might not be as quick as what you see in some Instagram transformations. But these are typically not realistic transformations in the first place. Having realistic expectations and understanding how fast the body can lose fat in a healthy way can help us determine whether you are in a fat loss plateau or not. My definition for a fat loss plateau is that all of your progress measures have been at least stagnant for 3 weeks. Meaning that for at least 3 weeks, there is no noticeable change in your body weight, body measurements, or progress pictures and how your clothes fit. If for 3 consecutive weeks, there's no significant sign of progress, then yes, we need to do something about this. But if there is progress in these past 3 weeks, keep it up. Even if it's slow progress, the slow progress adds up over time. I like to think in the big picture when it comes to fat loss progress. In 2 years from now, you probably won't care if your fat loss phase lasted 5 months instead of 3 months, but you'll care about having achieved fat loss progress in a healthy and sustainable way. There are exceptions, of course. If your progress is very slow and you have ambitious fat loss goals, then you can still use some of the tips discussed in this video to further enhance your progress. On to the first tip on how to break through a fat loss plateau, and that is to audit your diet. And specifically, we want to audit for 2 things. Snacking in between meals and the accuracy through which you are tracking your calorie intake. Now listen, I am a snacker myself. I like to have some popcorn after dinner and maybe grab a piece of chocolate in the afternoon, so I'm definitely not saying that snacking in general is always bad. But if your snacking is not controlled, the calories of the small little snacks in between your meals can add up. This helps explain why research shows that people that snack more in between meals are more likely to regain the weight they lose. Do your best to manage the type of snacking in which you walk to the kitchen and grab a handful of nuts or maybe some crackers. If you want to go for a snack, we can fit this into our calories and be just fine. But we essentially want to avoid that you consume more calories than anticipated due to subconscious snacking. And having many small snacks in between your meals typically doesn't fill you up much. Oftentimes, we are better off reserving our calories for 3 to 4 proper meals in a day rather than having many small snacks throughout the day. But this will also depend on your dietary preferences. The reason that I mentioned this diet audit as the first solution is typically also because a fat loss plateau occurs due to things like subconscious snacking or subconsciously eating more calories than anticipated. As a part of metabolic adaptations, our appetite tends to increase as we stay in a calorie deficit. This can increase the urge to snack, and many people are less likely to track those small bites, which also helps explain why it's common for people to underreport their daily calorie intake. So before taking drastic actions like doing a lot more cardio or restricting your calories even further, do a diet audit and look within and see whether your calorie tracking accuracy can potentially be improved. So say you have done an audit on your diet and everything is all good, you passed the check, but still things aren't progressing. What to do now? Well, before dropping your calories further, let's consider a diet break, which is the second fat loss plateau solution. I've covered diet breaks in my last video as well, but let's now look into the use of diet breaks in the context of a fat loss plateau. If you have been in a fat loss phase for more than 10 weeks and now your progress measures are stagnant for 3 or more weeks, it's possible that you've experienced metabolic slowdown and now can benefit from doing a diet break. During a diet break, you purposely go out of a calorie deficit and eat around maintenance calories. Next to having a mental break from eating lower calories, a diet break also has physiological effects. And the most beneficial physiological effect in the context of managing a fat loss plateau is that a diet break can help you reverse metabolic adaptations. If your daily energy expenditure has decreased as a result of being in a calorie deficit, maintaining a diet break can help us rebuild this energy expenditure back up. The higher calorie intake during a diet break results in higher energy levels, which helps you recover your metabolic rate, your spontaneous activity might also go up, and all of this together can help you recover your daily energy expenditure. Because a diet break helps you recover your daily energy expenditure, the idea is that after a diet break, you can return back to your normal fat loss calories and start losing fat again. For most people, a good way to diet break is to increase your calories by bumping up your daily calorie intake by 300 to 500 calories. By how much you should increase your calories during a diet break will depend on by how much you have been restricting your calories in the first place. Let's say you lowered your daily calories by 400 per day for more fat loss. You saw some good progress at first, but now there's a plateau. During a diet break, you bump your calories back up by 400. After 1 or 2 weeks of maintaining this diet break, you can return back to your old fat loss calories, and typically you will notice that you will get some good fat loss progress again because your body has had the opportunity to recover its energy expenditure during the diet break. The benefit of doing a diet break is that you don't have to constantly keep restricting your calories to lose more fat. Sure, having a diet break does take time, so your fat loss progress won't be as quick as when you push it all in one go. But I would argue that it's better to go for a slow process that is sustainable than to go for something that's very fast but hard to maintain and you may not eventually be able to stick through. Now, if you have done an audit on your diet and also went through a diet break and there still is very little fat loss progress or you are in a plateau, then this is where the third fat loss solution will come into play, and that is simply creating a larger calorie deficit. Increasing your activity or reducing calorie intake then is the logical next step and sometimes is simply necessary to continue making fat loss progress. The first step that I take with most of my clients in this situation is by either decreasing daily calorie intake by 10% or adding a 30-minute daily walk. This usually provides that boost in the calorie deficit that's needed to lose fat again. Both of these solutions increase your calorie deficit by about 200 per day, which should be enough to start seeing more significant progress in your measurements. Whether you should increase your cardio activity first or lower calorie intake first will depend on the individual. Do you feel good at your current calories and think that you can quite easily drop your calorie intake by another 10%? Then making a calorie decrease first makes sense. But if lowering your calorie intake further sounds tough, then it makes sense to go for a 30-minute walk on a daily basis instead. And if you don't have time for a daily 30-minute walk, you can also perform 3 30-minute more intense cardio sessions per week to increase your calorie deficit to a similar extent. So to sum up this video, there are 3 fat loss plateau solutions. First, audit your diet to make sure that you haven't been subconsciously eating more calories than anticipated. Secondly, if you have been in a fat loss phase for more than 10 weeks and there is no progress, consider a diet break to help reverse metabolic adaptations. And finally, if after the diet break there is no progress, aim to increase your calorie deficit by dropping your daily calories by 10% or increasing calorie burn by adding cardio. And that was all for today's video. I hope you now have a better understanding on how you can manage a fat loss plateau. If you found this video helpful, then definitely leave me a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. And I will see you in the next one.